Hi, welcome to Uber Micro Repairs. We've got a weird one. Here's the note. Here's the controller. And yes, that is a hair bubble around this PS4 Battle Beaver controller. And according to the customer, back buttons no longer work. Triangle, circle and X on the faceplate no longer works unless touchpad function is pressed down with a bubble. Okay, let's get this on the tester and confirm them faults. Okay, we can see B17 is actually pressed down and that will be from the bubble. So we'll just run around the buttons. Okay, shoulder and triggers work, rear buttons. Oh, that one's stuck. There's no click on that at all. Okay, so that rear button there is completely jammed. Face buttons. Oh, this has got a face clicky kit in it. So, yeah, not working, not working, not working. That one is. D-pad is okay. Okay, start and select work. Right, let's get rid of this bubble. We've probably got the best part of two flex cables stacked on each other. That's because there is some sort of clicky face button going on, although there isn't on the D-pad, so that's weird. And we've also got rear buttons. And I'm not sure if this is reprogrammable. So, yeah, let's get this apart and see what we're dealing with. This controller was assembled by Justin T. I don't think I've had the pleasure. Okay, Justin T. Mod work is nice and neat. And yes, this is a programmable mod. Okay, so we've got some hot glue over these pins. That would be to help sandwich the front button flex and also this mod flex, so we need to release that hot glue. We can do that with a bit of IPA. That should pick straight off. Nice and easy, there we go. One whole piece. Okay, I'm going to have to take the hot glue off here so I can get the board out properly. Okay, there we go. Just be careful that pulling on any of them flexes. I think we are a little bit there. There we go. Okay, cool. Okay, it would appear that this right stick has got extra tension in it. Ooh, okay, that's a weird flex cable. So we've got a set of Omrons on there, just on the buttons, and then we've got a standard D-pad over here. Okay, not seen one of them before. The first thing we need to do is to clean the PCB and both of these flex cables. So clean Q-tip and some IPA, just give them a quick going over. Obviously we need to do underneath, but it is soldered to that center button there, so I've got to be careful. Can't really get right under that. I'm going to have to undo that. Just We'll just reposition that. About there. We'll just hit that solder joint again. Okay, that's on there. That's good. I'm just going to remove these caps so I can get it in and out of the shell a bit easier, because we're not interested in the analogues just yet. And put the PCB back into the mid frame. And then the mid frame into the front shell. Try and get that touchpad cable to come through, like so. One screw in it. And I'll just grab a test USB board. So when the flex cables are correctly sandwiched and they're not damaged, dirty, or insert random reason, just having that one screw in there should be enough for everything to work. So let's give it a test. Okay, we're back in the room. No, we're not. Yes, we are. Okay, so we don't have anything on that trigger or that bumper. Okay, so those two are dead. And nothing on the D-pad. And back to there. Okay, that's fine. It was sort of semi-consistent. If I put some pressure on it, still nothing. Okay, this is weird. Wasn't expecting to make it worse. Okay, let's just undo that. Maybe the old PA isn't fully dry. We'll just remove that. Yeah, I think that's still a bit wet. Just give that clean. Put the board back in. See random things lighting up as and when the boards are making contact. Okay, so we've restored that connection, so we've got both triggers now working. Let's just do the face buttons. Sorry about the angle here. Okay, so those three are still dead. Okay, what I want to do now is actually test those switches, because those switches could have become faulty. Use the multimeter, we'll put it in continuity mode so we get a beep when we make a connection, like so. And if we put those two on this switch, which we know is working, we get a beep. And this one was definitely not working. We'll get a beep. Switch is okay. That switch is okay. And yep, that switch is okay. So the switches are working. Now, the next thing, I want to get this under the scope. And we'll just check those joints and the pads that those switches are actually soldered to. Square, which is this one, that works. Well, they all work, but that one definitely has a connection to the PCB. Sorry about the reflection. What have we got going on here? So what I need to do is check that ground is going to all of these here. Notice that this trace here, which is going to be ground, and it's daisy chaining to these three switches, and it's not daisy chaining to this one. This one is ground here, I think, and it goes underneath the switch and comes out here. This one is probably the signal wire, which is why this one is working. So this one has its own ground and signal. These have a signal. See how these are not daisy chained? So they're all separate. They all go past and this one goes underneath and over, but the grounds are. These three that are faulty all share something in common, and that is common ground. If I get the multimeter again, still in continuity mode. So we have a ground here. We should get a beep if we go here. We do. We get one there. Okay, so these are all connected. So maybe the signal wires could be broken. What we need to do is get this flex cable out of the shell, which isn't going to be easy because we actually have something soldered to it. Okay, so let's remove these wires for the trigger buttons. Like so. Carefully take this off. Oh, hello. Why is there a standard PlayStation Flex underneath here? That shouldn't be there. Should it not? Why is that there? That's not making... Oh, I know why that's there. That'll be there because... No, I don't know why that would be there. That makes no sense. Okay. Weird. Okay, I think this part of the flex is glued down a bit. Or double-sided taped. I'm not sure. Okay, freed up that. Trying to free up this. Try and get a little bit of heat on that. Okay, that's got it. This is weird. Why does it have the standard PlayStation one underneath? Okay, there we go, finally. I can't see any reason why that PlayStation one would be under there. Unless it's to act as a shim to make it a little bit taller than what it is. I do not know. Okay, so we've established we have ground across three of the switches. Which we do, we get beep. So we need to make sure that the grounds are actually making a connection all the way over to the flex here. So if I put that there, just double check that's there, and it is. We can sort of follow this trace to roughly where it is. It should be one of these. We've got a break. Got a break. I'm actually combing across all of them. We should be getting a beep. If I was to put it on there, see, we get a beep. And then this side, yep, we get another beep. But this ground here, yep, we've definitely got a break. Let's check it out under the scope. Let's just follow this trace. So that we've got it here, goes all the way around here, down, passes through the PlayStation button, comes back up and comes back up here, and it wires off to here to the D-pad buttons and goes up, and it should land there, right there on that pad. So that's the pad we're interested in. So if I stick the probe onto that one, we get nothing. And that goes directly to that pad there. We get nothing at all. And we're obviously not going to get anything on the D-pads. And just move over to here. Yeah, we definitely get nothing there. So I'm wondering if there's a break right close to this. And we super zoom right in. Sorry about the light. Do the best that I can. If I had to guess, the break would be right there. Right where that is. And unfortunately, I think the rest are going to be like that. If I was to scrape away some of that, if I was to scrape away some of this Captain Tape to reveal copper, like so, I'll put a probe on that there. We get a connection, but we don't get a connection here. Maybe that via is broken, because that's where it does sort of bend. So let's just do another one here. Put the probe on that there, and then go over to here. Still don't get anything. That's weird. Get nothing. We get something there. Everything looks perfect. All the way down here. Ah, what's that? It's a tiny little mark. Oh no, that'll be me. No. Well, the only thing I can do is just start making some points to probe. Apologies for the glare. But what I've done, I've just created some probe points. So from there to there, we're good. From there to there, we're good. 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 Not good. Beep. 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 No beep. And nothing there. Now that doesn't look broken to me. We've got nothing there and there. 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 Okay. This is trolling us because that looks perfect to me. So there is a break in there, believe it or not. Oh no, we're okay. What is going on here? That makes no sense. And now you're probing further down the line, straight to there, get nothing. We're back to nothing again. Could it be the PlayStation flex cable underneath? Let's just separate those with a piece of plastic. So there's no way they can touch. Let's try it now. So we'll go straight to there, to there, nothing. We definitely got a beep then. Right, there is something weird going on here because I'm pressing in the middle there. How about if we just solder a jumper wire? If we solder a jumper wire from a known good point, like here, and then we just solder it there. So let's do that. Let's get some flux and tin up those points. Okay, that's tinned. Okay, that's not great. Not great at all. I think I went a bit heavy-handed on that. That's a bit better. And let's get some wire. Let's plant our wire there. Perfect. And we'll make sure that there's plenty of slack in the line. Okay. Cut that wire. Let's do it off to the side because we'll cut over that trace. Like so, and retest. Go from there straight to there, and we now get a beep. So if we go from here, now we go over to the switches. Nothing, nothing, nothing. Okay. Let's just double check that. So we've got no beep. Really, no beep. Ah, multimeter went off. Okay, so we go from here. There's a bodge wire. Okay, we've got a connection. We'll keep that there. We'll move over to here. Yep, we've got a connection. And here, connection, and here we have a connection. Okay, so that has restored the connection. There is some weird break in that line. something that I'm probably not going to investigate any further. I feel we've done enough for this. We'll leave it right there. So we'll just clean up this flex cable, clean up all of our flux and mess. Well, good, and we'll just feng shui that wire to where we want it. Like so. I think we'll just put a dab of conformal coating over it, just to keep it in place. So, and a little bit there. Flatten that out a little bit. Just put a little bit over these test points that I created. Okay, we're good. Okay, happy with that. Let's get the lamp, cook that off. Excellent. And what we want to do now is just get some clean BSD safe blue roll and just give this a good going over. Just make sure all the residual flux has gone. Go both sides of that. Give that a good clean away on that, and then we'll clean away on that. So I've actually figured out why the standard PlayStation Flex is on the back here, and it's actually for the D-pad, which is somewhat clever because they've just got holes. They've just got holes there. So they're using this flex for the carbon tracks for the D-pad, which is weird, but fair enough. I mean, it's actually quite clever because they can install switches here if they wanted to, because we've got the pads there. And I would assume it's the same for this side as well. They seem to have glued it over the holes, but yeah, there are holes there. So you can pick and choose whether you want certain buttons to be the soft, squishy rubber one or the nice mouse button click. So yeah, that's not too bad, Battle Beaver. Impressive. Right, so let's get this plumbed back in. I won't be doing the triggers, I'll just move them out of the way for now, because there's no point in getting absolutely everything installed. We just want the bare minimum so we can test the bits that we're having problems with. Once we've confirmed those are okay, then we can carry on reinstalling and making everything else work. Go, we've just got the thing basically put together. I'll just hold the PCB down. So, moment of truth, will it work? Yay, it works. Yep, works, and this one works anyway. Fair enough, good. Working, yep, cool, good. Brilliant. Excellent. Okay, we might have an issue with triangle here. It could be just that I'm holding it wrong. Oh, there we go, it is working. Okay, that's good. That's really good. So we can put that to one side and unplug that. And the next thing we need to work on are these switches, because this one is just completely dead. The only thing it does is just rattle backwards and forwards. There's no click to it. This one is there, but again, doesn't exactly feel all that great. So we need to remove these switches and replace them with some new ones. And we'll be replacing these with some moisture and dustproof switches. These actually have a rubber membrane inside of them. So they are a little bit more high quality as opposed to these ones, which don't have anything like that. They're just raw switches. And yeah, that one's completely gone, totally gone. Let's get these installed and then we can solder up the wires and button this up. There we have the switches installed and they are centered in the holes perfectly. I did skip over that because it's a bit of a nightmare to try and get these installed correctly while trying to film, so I'll just jump cut to that. Next thing we need to do is desolder these switches from the wires, and hopefully there's enough length there to reuse those wires. So let's get on with that. We've got our wires run, they're all routed, So we just need to put these button caps on. And yeah, they need a bloody good scrub. There we have the buttons on, both at nice even click, and they're a good distance away from the shell. They look good, feel good. Yep, they'll work quite well. So I'm just going to do a quick tidy up and then we'll be on to reassembly. Okay, so we're basically back together. No screws, but I think this is a good time to test the controller. There you go, moments of truth. Oh, what a surprise. Still the same. Okay, so I would say that this main button flex needs to be replaced. Again, Battle Beaver aren't going to sell me one of their flexes. The only thing that I can do is replace this with a extreme rate version, which I have. So I will need to pause the video, go and have a word with the customer and see if they're okay with that. The issue is that with the extreme rate, the whole lot are digital buttons, so that'll mean that the D-pad will have a clicky mouse feel as well. So I'll be back in a minute. Welcome back, and we have an answer from the customer and they're going to go ahead with the extreme rate face clicky kit. There we go, there he is. I know it says PS5 on there, don't know why, but this is for the PS4. one second ago for you guys, a couple of days for me, is that this is not working. The face buttons do not work. 1, 2, 3 did not work. After I've fettled with it, I made it worse. And now I think the D-pad doesn't work and possibly a couple of other things. Not to worry, those flex cables are very reminiscent to how the PS3 controllers used to be, where the pads would crack just as it went from the carbon track to copper and then up onto the solder mask. And just through pressure, it used to crack right at the copper and at the join of the solder mask. And I used to have to bridge it. So I think that those had cracked along between the gold and the track. So it is what it is. Let's get this apart, get this installed, and hopefully we'll have a working controller. We have advised the customers that we will need to change out these buttons because, as you can see, they're quite a different shape to standard ones. There we have the flex cables come out. I think it's a bit brave of them to stack so many flex cables on top of each other. So not only do you have the standard PS4 one here, this one, you've got the contact edge there, you've got this one, again contact edges stack. And then, of course, you've got the contact edge there for the button remapper as well. Quite a lot of layers to actually potentially go wrong. We'll definitely be removing at least one of these. We'll just have a quick look under the scope. I'll give you some idea what I was gibbering on about earlier. I think there might be some micro cracks along here. So let's get that in focus. So right where you've got the pad and then it joins onto the trace here, I think there might be some cracks along there and they're just being intermittently connected depending on how much is bent. So if we get a super zoom on that, see anything there. This side you can definitely see that they've arched up a little bit. Let's see if we can get one in view. Yeah, like there. You can see how it's sort of arched a little bit, and there's another one there. Here we go. The customer will have all the face buttons clicky, including the triggers and bumpers. And he's happy to go ahead with that, so let's get this installed. Okay, there we go, that's installed best as it can be. Good enough. Maybe we'll have to leave the backstops in there and just remove the switches. Just use a tiny bead of conformal coating just to keep that in place. There we go, that's staying put. Just do the same here, just to be sure it's going to stay where it needs to be. Okay, that'll do. There we go, there's our two. Hopefully you can hear it click. Feels good. Go, triggers are in, nice and even clicking going on there, perfect. And we need to put these inserts in here as well. There we go, perfect. There we go, happy go lucky clicking. Let's put that to one side. So I've got to go off and find some spare original buttons. Okie dokie, courtesy of my Scuf graveyard, we won't be putting in stock PlayStation 4 buttons. We can actually put some nice black ones in. They're not exactly the same as the Battle Beaver ones. The Battle Beavers are a little bit more rounded on the top. These are a little bit more squared off like standard buttons, so hopefully be happy with that. And what we need to do, we need to put these rubber plugs in the bottom like so, so it can interface the button correctly. There we go, and one more. Here, we'll just clean these holes out, as it'll be rude not to. Excellent. Yeah, they look cool. Yeah, good. Whoops. Tell you what I forgot to do. That was remove that and put the appropriate rubber bungs in there as well. So this one has got small rectangular ones that go in. Hopefully that's coming through on the camera. Nice subtle click to that, and he's got a really good feel. To be honest, that'd be pretty good for Street Fighter, to be honest. Yeah, definitely. Yeah, that feels a lot better. Yeah, cool, I like that. Normally I would test it at this point, but I'm going to be confident. I'm going to put the shell on. Tester on, see if it works. There we go. We've got the triggers going, bumpers going, D-pad, and the face buttons and the rear buttons here. We seem to have one not working. Okay. But at least the face buttons are working perfect where they wasn't before. So we just need to investigate this button. Wonder if a wire has come adrift while we were installing and checking. I'm trying to figure out what the problem was. We'll just investigate these wires. Okay, that one works. That one does not. I'm pretty sure both of these were working beforehand. So, multimeter. Do this and grow a third hand, I think. Okay, button works. Brilliant. So I wonder if a wire's come adrift somewhere. I mean, all of that's pretty much locked in with hot glue, so I'm not entirely sure it's going to be there. Connections here, and they're all on and solid. Don't worry about button 6 and 7, it's because the PCB is lifting from the contact, that's fine. So T2, I'll find a ground point, and I can actually test if the signal is actually getting right the way to there. Screwing this. Okay, we are working. And I believe it's this top one here. Okay, so we're making it all the way down to the mod. So it's not the button, it's not the wire. It's got to be that the mod has unmapped itself. It has to be. So let me just go and find the instructions to remap this, and we'll do that. Okay, so we have the instructions right here. Let's plug in the controller. Controller is on, so it's saying hold the top two most rear buttons on the controller while holding, press down of touchpad one time. The light bar will flash, letting you know that you've entered assignment mode. So two buttons on the back here, both of them down. Okay, it's flashing. Cool. Press and hold the rear button that you would like to reprogram. While holding, press and hold the button you would like to assign to the rear button, release the rear button while still holding the assignment button. Finally, release the assignment. Okay then, so this one, the back here, press, X, release, release, and then this one, here. Press, press, release, release. Simply press the touchpad to save. Okay, did that actually work? Okay, cool, yeah. So we've got that as X and that as circle. Okay, so at some point it just lost its assignment, probably while I was messing about with the controller, or maybe it wasn't assigned at all. But either way, one of those buttons was completely dead, no click, nothing, just completely stuck down solid, so those needed to be replaced. We have the Extreme Rate kit in here, and it feels absolutely amazing, to be honest. It really is quite nice. The triggers do have a bit more of a spongy feel to them, but that's just the soft mouse click that they have. It's still extremely sensitive. You can preload the trigger a little bit and then it will just go. So yeah, very accurate. Yeah, Street Fighter. That D-pad is perfect. Literally hardly any pressure. Getting the diagonals every single time. Perfect. Excellent. And there we have it. I still have to put 4 screws in this controller, but I think that'll do it for this video. Apologies if for it being a long one. That's the way it goes, and I think the customer will benefit better from this clicky Extreme Rate kit rather than the half and half, because that D-pad is amazing. That's cool. So if you have any issues with controllers, consoles, or any other device that you feel we could help you with, please get in contact. All of our details are in the description below. And as always, hope you enjoyed the video and take care.